3, 2, 1. Here we go.
Welcome to Lighthouse Live with Jordan Devitt, the show where we give God the glory from this generation to the next. And now to your host, Jordan Devitt.
Good morning and welcome back to Lighthouse Live. I'm your host, Jordan Devitt, and I am so happy that you joined me for another episode here on the broadcast. I want to thank Bishop Dan, the Bishop of Lighthouse Church of All Nations, and Pastor Garland, the senior pastor, for making this ministry possible. I honor you both, and I love you so, so much. And today, this message is surely going to bless your life. So I want you to share this broadcast for me so that someone can hear the message of the gospel preached today. We know it'll encourage and inspire lives forever. So my message today is about the power of vision. The power of vision. You know, there's a story I heard, and it's about an amazing, amazing thing that happened through someone who had vision. Around the 1950s, there was an island in the Bahamas called Hog Island. It was a rundown island that was more so a dump. The island was known to have wild hogs and even dogs running out around it with lots of dirt and pretty much nothing good there. One day, a man by the name of Murph Griffin, and this is a true story, he came to visit the area and decided to buy the island. Now, the government, of course, thought this guy was crazy. You know, what is this guy thinking, buying this island that there's nothing here? The man decided to change the name, just by changing the name to Paradise Island. And he began to build some hotels and a bridge there. Then he sold it, and someone began to build more buildings upon it. Today, that island is one of the most traveled to places in all of the Caribbeans. It has what we've probably heard, if you've ever been to the Bahamas or you know you want to go, you've probably heard of Atlantis. That is on it, a magnificent resort. Millions of people travel to go there, and this little Hog Island that was once a dump is now a million-dollar revenue stream island that literally people all over the world travel to just to be at and to spend time at their resorts. Vision. How much can change through vision? I want you all to know something today. It doesn't matter where you're from. It doesn't matter what people have called you. It doesn't matter your background, your history. It doesn't matter. God has changed your name. He's given you a new name. He's cleaned you up, and he's turned you into something wonderful. And I want you to know that this morning, there is power in your vision, and God wants you to dream again. He wants you to envision again. He wants you to have fresh hope again, because when you do, so much can happen. And for that man, Murph Griffin, many people called him crazy for thinking he could go and turn this Hog Island, nothing good there, into something amazing. But you know what? It doesn't matter, because now people are sitting there thinking, wow, this guy was a genius. And so vision has no boundaries. And today I want you to know that God wants you to have vision back in your life again. And here is how. Vision, first off, is the language of the Holy Spirit. Haggai 2 and 3 says this, "Who of you is left who saw this house in its former glory? How does it look to you now? Does it seem to you like nothing?" In the context, this temple was completely destroyed, the one in which was built by Solomon. It was a marvelous temple covered with gold and silver, so well established and made. Yet all of it was gone and wrecked by the Babylonians, these people. Now, the Israelites were left as the remnant, and the remnant had nothing, of course. But God calls them to build this temple. And of course, time had passed in between all this stuff that was going on, so there was an older generation who actually saw that temple in its original former glory. And what I love so much about this story is God says that that temple, which was so marvelous, there's a greater one coming. Listen here to me today. I want to prophesy to each and every one of you that whatever it is that God has done in your past, maybe you're left with, you know, not much because of a failure, a shortcoming, something that happened. And maybe you feel like you're a remnant and you really don't have love. Maybe you don't have many people by your side. I want to encourage you today that with vision, there's a greater coming. And God told these people there was a greater temple coming. There's a greater for you today as long as you envision. There's a greater car for you. There's a greater home for you. There's a greater marriage that, you know, God has in store for you that you can have, that God wants to develop more for you. Now, I'm not saying that we are supposed to go in a direction where it's not led by the Lord, of course, but what I'm saying is this, that God wants to advance all that you have with one thing, and it's called vision. He wants your relationships to be stronger, your marriage to be stronger. He wants everything to be better because that is what God does. He goes from glory to glory. He elevates and he brings you higher to new levels and greater seasons for your life. And so it doesn't matter exactly where you're at right now. Know that, yes, you may have seen some of what God can do in that former temple, but there's more in what God has for the future of your life and for the future temple that he's going to build for you all. Remember that. That is what Haggai the prophet was proclaiming, and that is what we can apply to our own lives today. So, know this, that vision is the language of the Holy Spirit. Vision is the language. There's certain things that you're dreaming of and that you're believing God for, and I want you to know that God is the one who all along the whole time is with you, rooting you on as you have those amazing dreams and visions for what you are believing him for. Vision, the beautiful thing about it is no one can tell you whether or not you can do something because it's not up to them to decide. It's only up to the Lord. So I'm going to give you a couple awesome points that you can take as you vision once again. And maybe you've lost a lot and you've seen a lot of things go. I promise you, God is in the restoration business. You know it to be true. It's all throughout his word. And so just follow these steps. And I promise you, this will help you to get back on your feet, get back going, get the vision back in your life, and to dream once again. The point number one is this, start where you are at. Write that in the comments, start where you're at. In Zechariah 4:10, it says this, do not despise these small beginnings. Now, this verse, I have tried to have it be a mantra for my life because it's so amazing. It's really so awesome. Don't despise the small beginnings. You know, it's easy when there's so little, and for this context, it's pretty much the same thing as what was happening in Haggai, very close together books, where these people had nothing, right? But you can't despise those small beginnings, those times where you're left with kind of ruins, where you're left with nothing. Know that in those times, it's okay to start where you're at, to build small, to begin to just get your feet moving, right? It's okay to do that. A lot of times, sadly, because people see that there's so much work ahead and there's so much that they have to do, and because they see that they are just a remnant or they are left with literally nothing or they didn't have a good start and there are people who are ahead of them, they disqualify themselves. And I want you to know there's no reason to ever disqualify yourself. Listen, if God can be for you, who can be against you? The answer is no one. Stay where your feet are planted and just move from where you're at. And that is what these people had to do. They had to learn to just pivot and move forward. They had to learn how to just say, you know what? This is where we're at, but we're going to move forward and we're going to advance God's kingdom. Don't be the person who's always throwing a pity party for what you don't have. Don't. Listen, I understand in times in life where there's certain things that, hey, bad things happen and it sucks. But you're not 16 anymore. You're not a child anymore. You have to put away those things. You can't expect that every single scenario in life is going to be catered to you. The Bible talks about how the rain falls on the wicked and the righteous, on the people who are just. It's going to happen. It's going to happen. But you have to be able to say, okay, it happened, but I'm going to move forward. Don't blame everything on what happened. Just say, all right, this is the case. I'm going to move forward, and I'm going to do what God has called me to do, even if it means I have to start with nothing. Be okay with it. Be humble enough to say, all right, this is where I'm at. I'm still going to go for it. So that's point number one. Start where you're at. Start where you're at. Believe where you're at. Don't despise where you're at. No, it's okay. Many people have small beginnings, but you don't have to stay there. God wants to bring you more and bring you higher in his kingdom. Now, the second thing is this. Write down the actual vision, dreams, plans, goals, hopes, aspirations that you have for the Lord to do in your life. Habakkuk 2:2-3 says this. And the Lord answered me and said, write the vision and make it plain upon tablets, that he may run that readeth it. For the vision is yet for an appointed time, but at the end it shall speak and not lie. Though it tarry, wait for it, because it will surely come. It will not tarry. The power of vision is something that can go beyond anything the world has ever known. Someone once envisioned a plane that would be able to go faster, quicker, transport people in ways that they'd never seen before. And it was invented. Someone dreamed that you can communicate across countries, across cities, across towns with a little square, and the phone was designed. Someone believed that they could reach millions of souls, touch and change lives, be able to communicate and do things through media, and radio was made, television was made, different things were designed and created because some person just envisioned it. Vision has no boundaries. Vision has no places that there is denial. That's the beauty of vision. But you have to be able to say, as much as people are going to say no to this, as much as people are going to think it's crazy, you continue on to do it. Maybe you've never seen certain things happen in your family. Maybe you've never seen certain things in your home. But I want you to remember, you can envision it and God can do it for you. But the first step is writing it down so that you have a goal and a target for your life. And this is so crucial that we do this. I know people may think, oh, well, this is cliche, or oh, this is something that, you know, I don't think that'll really do anything. I promise you, there is not one thing that the Bible teaches us that will not be effective in our life. We have to have faith, we have to believe it, and we have to do it. And writing down your visions, your goals, your aspirations, your targets, and having them somewhere where you can see them is one of the greatest things that you can ever do for your life. And I'm not joking, it is what God is calling you to do today. Whatever it is that you're believing God for, today, this very day, write it down. I promise you, I do this. I have a vision board in my room, a whiteboard, where I write down the things that I'm believing God for. And the reason is because I want a target. I want to aim. A lot of times in my life, I never had an aim or a goal. And so I didn't have anything to look forward to. I didn't have anything to work towards. So I just blew all of what I did. And as humans, this is something that actually happens so much. You want to have a goal, a target, something to look towards. And as long as you do that, God will guide you all along the way. Now, I'm not saying that God is going to give you everything unless it's in his will. What I am saying, though, is as long as it's in his will, as long as you are working towards it too, he will guide you and he will give it to you. And he'll give it to you in a way where he blesses you in increments. You know, he'll do it in a way that's so smooth that you're able to handle it and that you're able to take on everything that he wants for you to have in the right moments, in the right timings, so that everything could be worked out perfectly for your life. He's done this so much for me, and I'm telling you, I promise you, he will do this for you. So many motivational speakers, inspirational speakers, people in the world talk about this principle, and they don't realize they're just taking from the Bible. The Bible is the one who showed us this. So whatever it is that you're believing God for, whatever vision, whatever thing that you're dreaming of, write the vision down. That's point number two. And then point number three is this. Be patient. Galatians 6:9 says this. And let us not grow weary of doing good, for in due season we will reap if we do not give up. The sad thing is, in life, a lot of people give up so quickly because they're working towards something and they maybe don't hit the exact goal that they wanted. And I was saying this before, my last point, God blesses us in increments. He gives us things in measures. And it's not because he doesn't want to give you maybe something that he's going to give you down the line right away. It's just because he knows what we need in the moment and what's going to be best for us to handle at the time and season of our life. You know, for me, I have really, you know, I'm a big dreamer. I love to dream. I love to have visions of what I want to see happen. And I'm ambitious about it. You know, I love to work towards that. I love to just see it happen. And so one of those things is when I got married, I was right away wanting to own something. I wanted to own something so bad. I mean, I promise you, I was like, and I'm stubborn about it. I get stubborn. And I ended up renting a place. And it was because God knew I needed to learn some stuff along the way. I needed to learn about locations. I needed to learn how to pay bills. I needed to learn what was affordable. I needed to learn all these different things so that I would be able to not drown. And as time went on, you know, this last year, the Lord spoke to me again, and I knew that we were transitioning into owning something. I knew it. And automatically, I went crazy. I went big. I went, you know, this is what I need. This is what I have to have. This is what, you know, is going to happen. But God also knew, listen, you need to be able to do stuff where you're not going to drown. You need to be able to do stuff and take it in seasons and measures. And in the due season, God's going to give it to you. And it's as long as I don't give up. So I planned, I worked, I saved, I did all the things, me and my wife, and God gave me something that I thought would be, I'm just going to be honest, you know, a 3-bedroom, 2-bathroom, completely finished with everything in the exact location, with everything that exactly I wanted. But God gave me something that would be better for me so that I wouldn't drown. And so what I'm trying to just say to you all today is this. You make goals, you have visions, you have dreams, but you also understand where you're at in life, what God needs for you to have, what God is bringing you to, and how he is trying to help you to learn all along the process too. And what you have to do is you have to be able to stay focused on what God's called you to do in doing good, planning, getting everything together, and then he'll still give you what you need. But you have to react the right way when things don't happen the way that you intended and still keep the right attitude. And so today, I'm encouraging you all to be patient. Know that with all the things that are happening, be patient. The visions that you have. You know, if you're saying, God, this is what I'm believing you for. Be okay with being patient. Now, God is not going to take forever on things because Jesus is coming back soon. So there's certain things that do need to happen now for you. But also be able to know and trust God's timing. Trust in him for all that he's giving you. And when you do that, I promise you, he will be there for you more than anyone and take care of all of your needs. But you have to be able to stay focused, stay on track, and keep those targets for what you're believing God for. And so I want to reiterate on these points and then pray with you all very briefly. Number one is this. I spoke about how this man went to the Bahamas, he saw what was nothing, and changed it into one of the most amazing resorts and places in the world that everyone travels to and wants to travel to. I haven't been there. I would love to go there. You have to have vision. Vision is what takes where you're at right now and maybe what you've had in your life take place and turns it into something beautiful, something that was filled with hogs and dirt and turns it into a paradise. Maybe you're from an area where people have marked it off and said, nothing good comes from there. Or maybe you're a person from a family where you've never seen something good happen. Well, here I want to tell you, the Lord can do it. He can make you, and he will make you as long as you believe him and you trust him and follow his plans into something beautiful. What people thought, they don't even know because of vision. And that's what God will do. Vision is the language of the Holy Spirit. These people in the book of Haggai and even in Zechariah, when they had nothing, it was vision that brought them in to having this beautiful place of worship that God wanted for them. And for us, we must recognize that God has so much in store for us. But we have to have that vision, that believing in him, that trusting in him. Know that, yes, he's done things in the past for us, but he wants to take you higher. And that's something to be encouraged about today. He wants to take you higher. He wants to grow your relationships. He wants to take you higher, bring you even into more for the kingdom of God. Number three is this. Start where you're at. Be okay with where you're at. Don't let anything stop you. And move forward. Don't let anything hinder you. Just move forward. Start where you're at. Don't despise the small beginnings. Be okay with it. Be humble. And know, you know what? This is where I'm at. This is not where I'm staying, though. God is taking me higher. Be encouraged by that. And the way that you do that is you keep those visions. You keep those dreams by writing them down. Write the vision and make it plain so that you run to it. Have a target. Have a goal. Keep those dreams and aspirations out on the fridge. Put them somewhere so that you can run towards them. Write them down. Draw pictures of it. Do what you've got to do so that you will be able to have those visions in your mind and in your heart at all times. And then be patient. Trust God's timing. Don't just give up. Don't let anything stop you. Don't let a shortcoming make you quit. Things that I wanted, I didn't get right away. But it's okay. Those things will come in due season. But we've got to keep doing the right things. We got to stay faithful to God. We got to continue to tithe. We got to continue to be faithful to his house, faithful to the calling, faithful to the mission, the assignment that's on our life. That is what God is calling for us to do today. So I want to take this moment and pray with you all to have vision back in your life, to be restored and to dream once again. Father, I thank you today for vision. I thank you, Lord, that you bring vision in our lives. I thank you, God, that you restore it. Lord, I pray today that you would help us to write visions down, to start where we're at, God, to be people who don't think about where we came from, but know where we're headed. Hallelujah. Lord, I pray they would be patient. Even me today, God, let us all be patient in what you have for us. so that our lives, God, will be able to have what we need in the right timing, in the right season. Let us keep on doing good, not growing weary, and knowing there's a harvest that's coming, oh Lord, because that's what you say in your word. We love you sincerely, Jesus. We honor you today, and we bless your holy name. We thank you, God, that you're faithful and that you're true in all. And we love you. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, listen, I'm so happy that you joined me today. Oh, it's been such a blessing having you. And I want to say this again. I love you so, so much. And I appreciate all the support and all the people who are partnering with us to make this ministry possible. This would not be possible without your faithfulness and your love. And I'm telling you, God is going to bless you so much for it. I promise you, as you follow him, he'll take care of all of your needs and all of your desires. Now have a blessed, awesome, amazing day in Jesus' name.
Get your new book from Pastor Dan Willis, The Multicultural Church, Embracing Unity and Restoration. For over 40 years, Pastor Dan Willis has led a growing multicultural church community in the suburbs of Chicago. His insight, wisdom, and overall love for people are sure to bless and empower your ministry. Order your copy of The Multicultural Church, Embracing Unity and Restoration today. Log on to www.danwillis.org today and take your ministry to the next level.